Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Connor, and you're with my father,
Kevin.
And today, we are back once again with Tame Impala. It's been a little while. It's been, I think, over a year since we did Currents.
That's right.
So I had to decide, because a lot of people were asking that we do another Tame Impala record, so I had the tough decision of going pre-Currents or post-Currents. There's only one record post-Currents.
Okay.
I couldn't decide what to do for the longest amount of time. And then I don't know why one day I put on the Slow Rush. And it just... this is one album that I didn't really enjoy first listen. I don't know why. Or first couple listens. It just didn't do it for me.
Well, I'm going to fucking hate it.
You might hate it. I don't know. I didn't like it first, you know, when it came out. I didn't really enjoy it. I was like, it seems like a shittier version of I felt like he kind of regressed in a way. Like I felt like Currents was a really high point, and I felt like this was a step backwards. Then for some reason the other day, a couple weeks ago, I was listening to it and it clicked with me. Track number one, One More Year.
Remember when I was talking about vocals, where they sit?
Yeah.
That, right now, they're perfect.
Yeah.
For this song.
I love the mixing on this album.
When it dropped now,
yeah, I love that part.
Yeah. Great sounds, man.
Yeah.
That's a really nice melody there.
It's beautiful.
That was really nice intro. You know, it was it didn't blow my brain away, but it was nice. It was mixed really well. Didn't think it was him at the beginning. Really thought it was a feature because his voice was quite different. I don't know really? Why. I don't know what it was at the beginning. I seriously thought it was somebody else.
Interesting.
Then it kicked in, and then I figured it was him when things got going. Lyrics are really cool. I never wanted another way to spend our lives. That melody there is really, really beautiful. Mm-hmm. It's one of those ones that touches you, right?
Yeah, it can give you the shivers.
It can, yeah. It's really cool, right? But it's a great starter. And I from what I feel here, I think there's some better things to come.
Track number two, Instant Destiny.
Nice. Builder. I like that he brought it down because it was getting too much for me. That is it?
Yeah. Rah.
Yeah.
there.
It was okay.
Yeah, see.
It was an okay track. It didn't blow my balls right off. I think it was just, there was so much, it was just so much in your face, and his vocal was low, and it was just like, yeah, I'm about to do something crazy, no more than, and it was just really heavy, really heavy. My favorite two parts, and I'm going to tell you, is verse number two, where it was brought down,
mm-hmm.
and then there was some dynamics there, and it was like, if I'm feeling this, and then the outro.
Mm, yeah, with the synth.
With the synth, and then it changed the metal. Let's drink the magic potion of love and devotion. Let's see how it goes. And then that totally changed it up.
That was my first reaction, too, when I first listened to it.
Yeah.
I was like, almost identical first reaction. I was like, why is this track two? Like, why yeah. did he even think to put this on the record? I don't like everything coming in fast. I felt like the song came out of nowhere.
Yeah.
I was like, it felt like we got transported into a chorus.
You got a good point. It was like, here, Connor and Kevin, you jump right in there.
Yeah. It's like, you know, you just pick up the turntable and you just drop it somewhere.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
Like halfway in a song, it felt like. But my opinion has since changed. I really like where that is placed on the record. Track number three, Borderline.
I know the song.
You've heard it?
Do I know the song? If,
huh?
Like, this is from this album, or is it?
Yeah,
from this album. Okay. I've heard the song, yeah. I know this for sure.
I think it's the most popular off the album.
Fucking really catchy chorus, man. This is really good, man.
Mm-hmm.
I haven't heard this. I love the swagger of this.
Of the bass lines.
The way his vocals are. Bam! Like that, feel your hands.
Yeah.
And then his vocals. They're going together, right?
They yeah.
Nice and fat and hard. Take that out, please. That was great. That was fucking great. That was great. Great. I definitely heard
it on the radio or
yeah. I've heard well,
through something.
I'll tell you. On the borderline.
You've heard that.
I hands down knew that. I didn't know the lyrics at all. Is it the refrain? Yeah. The refrain where it goes, "Will I be known and loved? Is there someone that I trust starting to sober up? Hasn't been long enough." Well, that is fucking. That's really cool.
You haven't heard that.
I haven't heard that part. No. And then the outro with the, where it's when it really comes in with that fat, boom, boom, boom,
yeah,
and he's calling with bass. I think it's synth or I don't know, but his words are matching it, and they're both going like this
at the same time.
At
yeah,
the same time.
It's really cool. Track number four, Posthumous Forgiveness.
Well, I'm fucking with this song.
Yeah. He's speaking to his father.
Fuck, it's good.
From the grave.
Wow, Kevin Parker's incredible with his
fills
analog synth. Textures and stuff. I know he's a guy that dials in, right?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, what a fucking line, man. What a powerful track, man.
Yeah.
Great refrain there. Fuck, man, that was absolutely beautiful.
Brilliant song.
Fucking beautiful, beautiful track, man. Just had me fucking tearing up there when he was in the Abbey Road part, because it was, you know, when I had, my dad passed, you know, grandpa passed at 67, right? Mm-hmm. And there was shit that him and I didn't get to do, obviously, and you know, he never got to see really you grow up and all those kind of things, right?
Yeah.
But we had a good relationship. Like, mm-hmm. he loved me, I knew that, and we talked and we watched hockey and phoned each other and all that kind of stuff,
all
right?
All the time, yeah.
So I can't imagine where you're at, where someone's at. And we get a lot of people writing us about the strained relationships with fathers, especially, right?
Yeah.
Male, female, everybody sending these messages in, right? And this song really hits home to all the ones that I sit and answer and I talk to you about, is that it's really hard when somebody passes, because You can't get that shit out. And when he said, that really hit me, the fucking, I was ready to start bawling there, was...
The second part or the first part?
When I want to tell you about the time I was in Abbey Road, or the time that I had Mick Jagger on the phone.
Yeah.
Because those are those things you just want to tell your dad.
Call your dad and tell him. Yeah.
Yeah.
Track number 5, Breathe Deeper.
Got a little flam, listen.
Yeah.
Hear that? Rah! It's a flam or a trill or something. Well, that's sweet, man. What a different. The music is just fucking killer. That's so clear, eh?
Yeah.
Ah, fatty. What is this?
It's part of the track.
Oh.
Towards the end of it.
Ooh, I like that. Oh my god, this is great! Yeah.
Cool way to end it.
Oh man.
It's that heavy.
Wow. Wow.
Yeah, a little bit of a chaotic ending. Well, not chaotic, but you don't know what's happening until it picks
until
back up.
Until that kicks in, yeah. That was, and it was a really nice synth sound with great, great drums, right?
Yeah.
Parker's amazing. And what I wanted to say before I forget is that it takes a special person to do this because, I mean, I know a lot of people do it, right? I know there's a lot of people who do looping and all that kind of stuff and that, but, the discipline to go in and do it yourself and,
finish it.
Yeah. And to execute it in such a way that it's great and it's mastered and it's complete is I couldn't do it.
No,
I couldn't do it. I couldn't do it alone. I'd have to, I couldn't do it alone. Maybe you stick me there and show me how to do the stuff and give me the same gin and stuff like him, right?
In his little,
I'd need my hair like his
length. Little beach studio.
Little beach. It's fucking
big beach.
It's
studio.
Beautiful. Yeah. Yeah.
Grow your hair out and get some gin and tonic and
and go. But then you know what? I'd get into one groove and I'd be like fucking great. And I'd make 7 second MP3s and send it to everybody.
Yeah.
Check it out. And I haven't even finished it. Right.
Yeah.
I do,
and then you do something else.
I go on to something else because I get bored. But to stick with it and do it. But that was a really cool track.
Track number 6, Tomorrow's Dust.
Oh my God, I thought it was the beginning of Africa. Total. Wow, this is very fresh feel for. Mm-hmm. Feel that entrance?
Mm-hmm.
That's beautiful, man. All those intros coming in. That line there reminds me of what I do. Like in the air of today is tomorrow's dust. It's like I'm worrying about tomorrow and then weeks ahead and it's in.
And it's, the thoughts today is just going to be tomorrow's dust.
It's crazy.
That's why I love this track.
Yeah.
It reminds me of the Breathe Deeper. They go back.
Yeah, that's great.
Hand in hand.
I love him start with a guitar on that too, man.
The acoustic?
Yeah, it was really fresh.
Really nice change of pace.
I have to say, Connor, having the lyrics again for the, this is one of the ones that really give me an emotional connection through the lyrics.
Yeah.
And it is a calming song. And I'll give you a couple of lines. Yeah.
Yeah.
This is something I've been doing as an old guy here, and then there's no use trying to relate to that older soul. I don't know how he's meaning it, but for me is that I do look ahead to the future and like, you know, if I make it to 80 or 70 or what, and where your life is going to be and how I'm going to be, am I in a care home? I always look at that shit. It's weird, just weird obsessive thoughts. I always think about that stuff, but there's no use for me. I'm reading this as there's no use trying to relate to that older soul. Like, I'm seeing it as like, and then this is my perspective, is that I see it when I hear it is like me going and going, oh, fuck, what will I be doing then? And where will I be in my life at that time and all that kind of stuff? And that line really hit me. And then when it was like, then it started kicking in and in the air of today is tomorrow's dust is that is for me. That is like exactly what we just said. Mm-hmm. For me, it's like, I'm worrying about, yet tomorrow, like all the shit that's happening in a week from now, which I'm trying to control through, like, you know, like being mindful and shit like that. It's all that
all those moments where you're spent worrying is just going to be dust
like just be here and be present.
Yeah,
you know, think about this, right? Think about that moment. I'm getting better at it though, because I really am. Like, I don't, like, I'm thinking about what we're doing today and that's it. I don't know what I don't even know what day tomorrow is. What
no,
is
I don't know.
Yeah.
I try to be the same. I've gotten better over the years. Track number 7. On track.
I'm finding myself breathing deep.
Good.
I like where his voice is
on this track.
Yes. But strictly speaking, I'm still on track. Cool. Strictly speaking, I'm holding on. Strictly speaking, I just had this overwhelming feeling of happiness.
Yeah, that's what this song does to me.
Yeah. Fuck it, fat. I love this line. That is my second. It's tied with the Posthumous.
Yeah, that's my second favorite. It goes back and forth between that and Posthumous. I just absolutely love just the positive message it brings, and it can be applied to a lot of situations where you feel like, fuck, this is going wrong, this just happened. But if you look back at the grand scheme of things, you're still on track. As long as you got your dreams in your head. And you know, no matter how many minor setbacks or major setbacks you have, you're still on track at the end of the day.
And that's such a good way to think of it, because it's so easy to dig yourself into the hole. And I've been in the hole many times of just like, I just keep putting myself in that hole. And songs like this is what I'll go back to and listen and go, man, it's just, you know, I go back and listen to Mac Miller when I'm feeling down, and I just, and there's Mac's tracks that just bring me right back, and just like, man, like take a break, breathe, man, everything's going to be cool, everything's going to be all right. When you started this whole thing with me, I was probably at one of my lowest lows, man. I tell you, my body was breaking down. I didn't know what was going on with my life. It was just a really, really tough time. It was middle of COVID. I couldn't fucking go out anywhere.
Couldn't get a job anywhere.
Everything was a fucking mess, right? And I look at that time, and that's, you know, it's funny, because even though I'm at my age and it says you've got your whole life. I do have my whole life.
You do, yeah.
It's not that I'm 18 and I have my whole life. I mean.
Well, no, but from this present moment.
Yeah.
Till the day you die. Right now, that's going to be the whole rest of your life. So, and then, you have that whole life ahead of you.
And as Cuddy said, man, it's like literally, I've been reborn. Yeah.
Yeah.
And then that's the way I do it. It's like I put that other shit, the stuff that I went through. Yeah, I could look back and fucking have massive, massive regrets. You know what I mean? About life and shit I should have done and shouldn't have done and all this kind of stuff. But why do that? Why? Well, what's going to get me?
Track number 8, Lost in Yesterday.
It's pretty groovy. I already read the first two lines. I already like this song right now, man. Back when we used to get it on it for ourselves. This is fucking great, I gotta say. Eventually terrible memories turn into great ones. So if they call you No, I like this. Wow. That's good, man. Fucking great track. Great, Connor.
Top three for me.
Yeah, that's definitely number three for me. Wow. Wow.
Lyrics are just phenomenal.
Lyrics are phenomenal. I don't know what to say. I don't even know where to start here. Because it's so much in my head is that when we were living in squalor, wasn't it heaven? When I first met Mom, I'm going back to when I had... These teeth were all missing, right?
Yes, through what, hockey?
Hockey, an elbow, a BMX accident. I met your mom. All I had was a pair of jeans, a white t-shirt, and a fake Stratocaster. And I was playing at the bar. I told the story probably a million times. And those were some of the happiest times. Looking back, I look back on those, right?
Mm-hmm.
But then back when we used to get it on 4 out of 7, me and Mom used to get it on 7 out of 7. So just going to tell you, right? Maybe 12 out of 7 sometimes. So I'm just going to clear the air there. Not that there was any air to clear.
Yeah.
Then you look back, it's eventually terrible memories turn into great ones. Like mm-hmm. when I had a crinkled $5 bill, I'm not joking, man. Crinkled $5 bill in my pocket. That's all I had in my name. No teeth, 139 pounds wet, going and playing my songs in a bar. You could not, in my head, I was a millionaire.
Track number 9, Is It True?
Yeah,
I know you love those.
I love the way he combines bass and that fat synth.
Yeah.
Just makes it really thick. These change-ups, eh?
I think that, to me, that's one of the highlights of the album is these change-ups.
I know, it was just like, we're here, boom, boom, boom.
Yeah. That's a pretty short tune.
That was a good track, and it wasn't a dick blower, or whatever you want to call it.
Dick blower. Didn't blow your balls off.
Didn't blow my balls off. Yeah, yeah. It was good. It was fun. The synth was nice. I love the way that, you know, that tone that he takes with the fat bass. But then you also have a synthesized bass, which is at a different frequency and is like it. Mm-hmm. That's a really cool thing.
Yeah. Track number 10. It Might Be Time.
Oh my God, that one hit the stab. Reminds me of the Logical song.
Yeah, I know.
I don't like this.
You don't?
you ain't as young as you used to be. It might be time to face it. Wow, some interesting sounds here.
Yeah.
Sounds like in that line, he's like talking about his musical career, right?
Mm-hmm.
And he's...
I think you could apply it to a lot of different...
Yeah, it's true. Yeah. So. It's a bit of a harsh sort of eye-opener closer to the end of the song.
Yeah.
You ain't as fun as you used to be. You won't recover. Great fill there, man. Okay, complete opposite. Whoa. Shit, Kevin. What are you doing to me, man? Jeez. Wow, man.
What, Kevin's giving you a heart attack?
Yes, why'd he jump in like that, man? Complete different feeling for me than On Track.
Well, On Track was like a few tracks ago, though.
No, but
you
I
just mean in terms of... General lyrics?
Yeah, no, just a feeling. Like, On Track was very positive.
Yeah.
I felt a very positive thing here. I felt pretty fucking sad here, getting old. For me, what I was thinking of in terms of Kevin Parker's life, music is short.
Yes.
Short-lived, right? You're one day and you're gone, right? And then this line here, I've been lost before, so tell me it's not over, because finally I've got something going, and suddenly all my friends are growing up, they're moving on. I must be missing something, then, because I just want to keep this dream alive for now. Don't they know that nothing lasts forever? And then it's like, it might be time to face it. Nobody knows what you've come here for and whatever. So I'm interpreting it as like, it's, you know, his friends are growing up and getting married and having babies and stuff like that. And he's sort of saying, you know what,
this music career
doesn't always last forever. And it's just sometimes you gotta realize that you're getting older and embrace it.
Yeah, that's the thing I love about the record though, is there's each track can really be... Well, not each track, but most tracks can be
interpreted
in your own way.
Yeah, that's the beautiful thing about it. I love this album. I really do. I really love this album.
That song, yeah, definitely one of the darker one. Maybe not darker. I don't want to say it's dark, but it's
No. I'm just being an asshole. No, not darker. I'm just, you know, when it says you're getting older, whatever. Yeah. You know what? I've embraced. I'm old.
Track 11, Glimmer.
Crank the bass up, and it's like, no, not really.
That's from a bass player.
Yeah. Adding your own instruments.
Ready.
You can load up the next track.
Okay.
I'll just let it play into it. It's called One More Hour. Just a moment, right before all the sun ends. Man, it's a racing. Whatever I've done.
These big shots he's had on a few of these songs. Nice. What rolls, eh?
Mm-hmm.
I like that, those two lines there, how they're sort of looking forward, eh?
Mm-hmm.
Like this. You know when Kevin's coming in with those.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. See, these are the parts that blow me away that he's by himself.
Yeah.
Because you can tell they're not looped.
No.
Wow, it's acoustic here, right?
Yeah.
This is a really nice part right here, man. The strings.
And that's the whole album.
That was a cool track to end it. It wasn't the real, like, it was a build up and there was a lot of, whatchamacallit, lyrically that sort of summed up the album, right?
Mm-hmm.
And what, and the emotions and everything that's going on in that. And I think it completely did its job, right? But it wasn't the, you know what I mean? The big,
it didn't end on a big climax.
No, it wasn't a gorilla's end.
No. Right? It just kind of, I like the ending though, because I felt like I didn't need some big climactic ending to that, you know. It was a soft
walkout like this.
Yeah, like carrying exactly. Yeah. Because there's the parts where it picks up and then goes back down slow, and then the end. To me, the final moments of the album are great when the acoustics come in and the strings, and then it's the consistent drum beat, and it just
that was that
carries,
outro, and it was
and then it just carries out to the end, and then it's a little fade out, and then,
You know what? It sounds corny or something that weird, but it for me that reminds me of like that song at the end reminds me of an ebb and flow of the tide.
Yes,
and then when the tide's finally going out, it's doing its thing, and the time has done its thing, and the water's going out. Oh, I didn't smoke anything on the break, by the way. I just urinated.
No, that's a perfect way to
and it just sort of it. Then it went because and then it just teeters at the end, like the you know
like
what I mean,
like a wave,
like a wave, like you're at the end of the night, and then it's going away, and time is the essence, and time was fantastic on this album. It was a really cool album. I unequivocally have a preference for this album
over Currents.
Over Currents,
and me too.
Then I'll just tell people that because I know Currents is probably a more popular album. With the big hits on it, but this one really resonated with me. I thought it was his, out of the two personal albums, it was his more personal. I think it was his best lyrical album out of the two. Mm-hmm. I've only heard the two. And I think it really touched in places for me and in you, and probably it resonated with a lot of listeners who have listened to this album on various levels of degrees of where they are in their life. And I think having said that, like I said earlier, that this album is one of those things that brings up the subject of me, what I said earlier, is that brings up the subject of me, no, not me, of what I said earlier about really embracing the time that you're in.
Yes.
And there could be a bad time, but in that bad time, you're going to look back and there'll be good times within that bad time, believe it or not.
I had a lot of fun today. You had fun?
I had a lot of fun because I feel good today. So
me too.
And it's always fun.
And I hope you guys had a good time. If you made it all the way to the end, just want to give you a huge thank you. Like always, uncut version on our Patreon. Feel free to check that out if you'd like. And stay tuned for some more album reactions this month.
Yeah. Maybe possibly a spooky one for Halloween.
Yes, Halloween. I asked people to send in their Halloween album recommendations. Ooh. So we're planning that out.
Yeah.
And I'm excited for that. So,
and you know what? While we're at it, throw on some costume ideas in the comments.
Yes, I'd love costume ideas. Yeah, so if you made it all the way to the end and you put a costume idea, we'll definitely read it.
We'll definitely look at it. Yeah, because I want to dress up this year, right? And every year I dress up the same stuff. And
yeah, me too.
Right? But I want to do something different this year.
Okay. Thank you guys so much.
Thank you guys. Take care.
Stay safe, and we will see you soon.
Bye-bye. Peace.